You remember when vampires were cool and they weren't all like sparkly and pretty and shit? Well, Jeff Ryan does. Oh yeah, he does. Blood from Stone is brought to us by director Jeff Ryan and stars Vanya Kapnovic and Gabrielle Toth. We follow Daria, played by Toth, just a young woman trying to live her life and get by in Las Vegas. She's a bartender by night and wants nothing more than to just find love and live a nice, simple, normal life. When Daria's alcoholic ex-boyfriend Joe suddenly shows up one day and starts causing trouble, things in her life start to get a bit more difficult. You see, Daria's moved on. She doesn't want anything to do with Joe or the life that he represents. Unfortunately for her, Joe never quite got over Daria, and he is still heartstruck in love with her and just won't give it up. And him showing back up starts to cause some really big problems for Daria. So she resorts to calling Joe's older sister for help so that maybe she can convince Joe to leave her the hell alone and move on. But of course, it's not gonna be quite that easy. Oh, and yeah, I forgot to mention, they're all fucking vampires too. Blood from Stone is a new independent film from director Jeff Ryan that honestly I had never heard of until I had it sent to me. And after sitting down and giving it a watch, this is something special. As I mentioned a moment ago, this movie does concern vampires, but I don't know if I'd really call it a vampire movie. It's definitely got some vampire antics in it, that's for damn sure, but this is much more just about these two people and this issue that they have with their relationship, or really the lack thereof. The basic story here is pretty relatable. You have a failed relationship that one of the parties wasn't ready for it to be over. This is something that pretty much everyone has either been through or witnessed someone else they know going through. Many of the issues and problems that pop up in this movie are very human issues. Yes, these are vampires that are dealing with these issues, and they do have a few extra hurdles because of that, but the core issues they're dealing with, the core story of this movie, is a very human story. This is not a big action fest. It's not even a horror movie. Now, I mean, there are some parts that these vampires throw down, but the vast majority of this story is very much a drama. It's about these two characters and how they're dealing with this failed relationship. The movie does a fantastic job of slowly giving us information about these characters over the runtime. There's never some big, like, exposition dump to tell us all about vampires in this world. We don't get all that information. We do get some. I mean, we get enough information to let us know how vampires work in this world. And we also get a nice amount of backstory to these characters and the lore just to keep us interested in what's going on. But it's never too much. There's never a part in the movie where it gives out all this weird information that two people that already had the information wouldn't be talking about, i.e. exposition dumps. No, we find this stuff out through natural conversation. And one of the things we do find out about vampires in this world is that some of them are kind of a fucking shit show, i.e. Joe himself, the biggest fucking shit show of all. Daria's trying to get her life together. She's not hunting people. She has like a deal worked out at a local hospital where she gets blood and just drinks from that at home. She's trying to be as normal as possible, and you find out in this world of vampires that that's okay. There are vampires that do that, and the other vampires don't like point fingers and blame them or anything. They're more or less just kind of like, whatever, do your own thing. If you want to do that and just stay on the low, go ahead. If you want to hunt, go ahead and hunt. Just don't call a lot of attention to yourselves, and in turn, all of us. And this is where Joe fucks up, because Joe ain't about that low-key life. Joe is a fucking alcoholic hardcore partier, and Joe is all about the hunt, so much so that it's pretty much a fucking addiction for this guy. He goes out what seems like every night and just slaughters the shit out of people. And in a modern-day world, that's kind of hard to get away with. They even bring that up at one point and talk about, back in the day, we could do this kind of thing. It would be explained away by, like, gods, monsters, and superstitions and stuff like that. But nowadays, no, people aren't about that life. They find fucking murdered bodies all over the place, and investigations ensue, and they're pretty good at finding out who the fuck did this shit. And vampire or not, you leave evidence behind, and Joe's not really, like, careful about this shit. Now, while we do get a decent amount of vampires hunting in this movie, the vast majority of it is characters talking. Character building, story building, world building, lots of building here. But it is all done so well that I was just riveted from beginning beginning to end. The story is never boring, and it seems like it has so much to tell you about this world. This is such a rich world, and we only get to scratch the surface of it. It is masterfully told, and they give you just enough information to keep you foaming at the mouth for more throughout the runtime of this film. Now, to add to all that is the characters and the performances. Everybody here does a wonderful job, but Kapnovik and Toth are absolutely fantastic here. You absolutely sympathize with the character of Darya. She just wants a normal life. She wasn't born into this life, she was brought into it, and she wants to go back to the way things were. Now, we get the feeling that she's been this way for a really long time, but that doesn't change the fact that she misses normality, and that's what she's striving for here. But it's almost heartbreaking that it seems like that normality is always just right outside of her reach. No matter what she does, no matter how much good she does, she tries to do what she's supposed to do at every turn, but it's always just right there outside of her reach. And it's pretty fucking heartbreaking to see that. Now, one of the big reasons why all this stuff is outside of her reach is the absolute shit show, Joe. Kapnovik is absolutely stellar as Joe. He is a shit show of a person who pretty much ruins everything that he comes within 10 feet of. He violently murders people en masse every single night. And not only seems like he can't quite get his shit together, it seems like he doesn't really want to get his shit together. But even with all that stuff I mentioned, you still sympathize with this character. He comes off as extremely likable. He's not really murdering people in his eyes. This is just how it is. He is a creature and that's what they do. Now, the shit show part, that's all him. He just can't get his shit together. This guy's like the poster child for a fucking shit show. And he takes alcoholism to new fucking levels. I mean, he is such an alcoholic that he won't feed on people unless they themselves are drunk so that he can get drunk off of their blood alcohol content. It comes to the point that there are some times in the film where he will get people drunk before he will attack them because he doesn't want anything to do with your blood if there ain't alcohol in it. But you do see that he truly does want Darya to be happy. He just can't accept the fact that he's not going to make her happy. He wants her happy, but he wants her happy with him. He's obsessed. He just can't let it go. But even with these terrible character traits, the guy is still very likable and at times sympathetic. Much like Darya wants that normal life that is right outside of her reach, he wants Darya, who is right there outside of his reach. Both of them are wanting something they just can't quite have. And both of these actors did a fantastic job of conveying all of that to us, the viewer. When I go into independent films I've never heard of, sometimes you don't know what you're gonna get from the performance side of things. While yes, you can get some really great performances from unknowns in these movies you've never heard about, you can also, more times than not, get some pretty lackluster performances from unknowns in movies you've never heard about. Thankfully here, everybody on screen does a wonderful job, but especially our two leads do a fantastic job here. These are some wonderfully fantastic performances. Something else this movie does really well is it just looks good. As a whole, you wouldn't know that this was a low-budget independent film. It looks great from pretty much every technical standpoint. What I really enjoyed was the effects. They never went too far. You could tell that they knew what they were capable of here, and instead of trying to exceed that and it looking bad, they stuck within their wheelhouse and just tried to make that look great. And they totally succeeded. This does come off as a bit more of a grounded version of a vampire type story. Now, that doesn't mean that there's not a lot of blood, because yes, there is a lot of fucking blood in this movie. Actually, that's one of the things I really liked about it, was that when these vampires attack, it is not clean in the slightest. Like, from none of them, it is messy and nasty and bloody, and it's just fucking everywhere. When they rip someone's throat open, blood goes fuck all everywhere. There is no like attacking someone and then going about your day. No, you gotta like change clothes, take a fucking shower, and get totally cleaned up. These motherfuckers are messy as shit. And it was pretty fucking glorious. All of the effects here are very believable. They're never too over the top, but there is plenty of fucking blood. Especially from Joe's character. This guy gives no fucks. I mean, he slaughters people and is just covered in fucking blood walking around Las Vegas. Like I said, guy's a fucking shit show. Overall, technically, this is just a really good-looking movie, and I really did appreciate the fact that they never overstepped their bounds when it came to their effects. Now, the ending of this movie, at first glance, is going to be something that may bother some people. Some people might say, well, all the issues weren't solved. I mean, some of them were, but not all the issues. But that's kind of the point. I don't think that some of these issues were supposed to be solved. Some of the issues brought up for these characters are big, huge issues. These are not things that were ever going to be solved. It's less about solving the issues and figuring out how to live with these issues. Now, some of the smaller issues they have are definitely solved, but some of the big, broad issues, it's more about figuring out how you're gonna live your life with them. Nobody's solving this stuff. It's age-old issues that will continue to be issues for years to come. Also, this seems more like it's just more of a snapshot of time for these extremely old beings. They got a whole lot more life on either side of this story. We're just seeing this part right here, so it's kind of hard to say that there's a definitive end. I mean, there is, and I myself was very happy with the way this film ended. But without spoiling anything, I could see some people having complaint with the way that the movie ends. The movie also seems a bit longer than it really is, but not necessarily in a bad way. Now, I'm not gonna lie, there were one or two times that I saw how long I've been watching the movie and thought to myself, holy shit, I feel like I've been sitting here a lot longer. But it was a weird thing because I was never bored. I was absolutely invested in what was going on. I was never looking at my watch or anything like that, wondering what time it was. Honestly, the only reason I noticed was I had to pause the movie at one point and I saw how long it had been on. If it weren't for that, I never would have known, but it doesn't change the fact that it did seem like I had been sitting there a bit longer than I had been. But also, I don't really see this as a negative because I was never bored. I was enthralled all the way to the end, so I don't know. I guess maybe I'm just trying to find something to nitpick here because everything else about this movie is so fucking good. Guys, at the end of the day, Blood from Stone was a fantastic watch. I'm really glad that I got turned on to this wonderfully unique indie film. And there truly is nothing else out there like it. This is a very unique film. It's got some fantastic performances, a wonderfully interesting story, and overall it's just a very interesting looking movie. It's a very unique film that I guarantee you're not gonna see anything else like this anytime soon. And because of that, and all the other reasons I mentioned, Blood from Stone is absolutely a unicorn. Since I gave one of those, but this movie totally deserves it. Now, it's currently available on Amazon Prime, so if you have a Prime membership, there's absolutely no reason for you to miss this wonderful film. So block out 2 hours one night, sit down, give this one a watch, and you will not be disappointed. So there it is, guys, my review of Blood from Stone. If you enjoyed, want more content like this, hit that subscribe button and help my little channel grow. If you liked what I had to say, give me a like. If not, let me know in the comments below why. And as always, stay sexy, Las Vegas.
Drink up. Kills all the pain.
Now, this isn't really spoiling anything, but there is a part in this movie where one of the vampire characters gets in a car and starts Ubering people around Las Vegas. And I'm sure you can guess what this vampire starts doing while taking these random people around the city. And it almost comes off kind of like that movie from earlier this year with Joe Carey called Spree mixed with a vampire. And I started to think, oh, is that what we're going? Is that what this movie's gonna be? Is that what we're doing here? This could be kind of cool. And it is for just a few minutes and then that part over. It's more like kind of a snapshot what could be. But the whole time that part was on, I thought to myself, you know what? I mean, really? That could make a pretty fucking cool movie. I mean, a vampire Uber driver riding around murdering the shit out of people? Why has this not happened yet? I mean, there you go. Free ideas, guys. Somebody take that shit and run with it.
Uberpire. Blood Uber. Uber of death.
I mean, just some ideas.